Well, hello everyone. You hear right here is like showing it right here is like say a sketch right here of me that I went ahead and drew, and like it could be like say an example of like say a sketch that went and worked is like in for our class it is, but basically that if most of us have ever thought about maybe writing a journal or a book or so say about our lives it is. And you see right here is that I would include right here is that this right here will be like say like a portrait right here of me based on one of my old school photos it is that I can tell anybody here that I had actually found it in my old wallet the one I used nearly over 10 years ago that I had an older wallet and telling anybody here that I found a the photo, but then I didn't find any money or anything like that. I'm like anybody per se, like if you're gonna find any money, maybe a few cents to a dollar or something like that. But on any hand, knowing about that you have right here of like say as a portrait right here, more likely about what I look like in the picture though that I actually have up to where my head will be turned at about more to the left, so it'll be kind of like to the right, but. On the other hand, and knowing about right here, talk about it's like the paper keeper story, and knowing about you have right here as an example right here of me, and that would have been about me whenever I was about 16, maybe about 16, 17, I think 16 and a half, something like that, whenever that, for that portrait right there. And then on the other hand, too, that you see right here is like say a sentence. Is if anybody were to think about it, it's like for the for the paper keeper story, knowing about the things that we're like talk about, like thought to keep and what we want to get rid of and toss, but so forth. But the things that like to keep, but knowing about about how it's how you pronounce words is knowing about if we were by me writing up paragraphs. Anybody probably say a lot of times if they will be testing you at the speed from how you write stuff, such as it's like going to class, going to class to turn in paper, and anybody probably think about it, it's like so far as the language goes is that knowing about for the most part it a way to how you say going to class to turn in paper. And then I know a lot of times, like the IQ test would go, I say going into class to turn in paper. So a lot of times, though, if we were to see these different sentences on their hand, too, that I can tell anybody here that, like, say, I used to be known as, like, which is the pertinent right small it is. Like, going, to class to turn in paper. And if anybody can see this here, is it, that I write like this, and if there's like a proper name for it, like say you tell President the language, you see the language barrier, if it's like say Times New Roman or anything like that. But basically that to say for like news updates or anything like that, the newsletter updates. Newsletter updates. And up for for updates and for new improvements, new improvements in the city. Anybody probably think about the way that everybody writes more likely is that like we say it's like a story, and I kept thinking about anybody probably think about from what we dream about if we dream. Or if we think that we talk to somebody about that anybody that probably goes by like say between the type of language and the knowing about that the types of dreams that of course that we more likely have and knowing about that we actually talk to this person, and basically that the whole story of knowing about that, that we think that, that we talk to them, of course, in our dream, and then they giving us a certain answer it is, you know, et cetera, et cetera. But just knowing about anybody probably think about that really, about, you know, do you think that you're hallucinating, such as that, you know, if you're able to communicate with somebody, you know, a certain writer or an artist or anybody, you know, somebody that's been gone for quite a few years, and just knowing about, I'm like, yeah, that I know about a source of ways of communication it is. But the way I think about it, you know, a proper name for, you know, any type of communication, of knowing about that, you know, somebody that's able to read, you know, the mind, it's like, you know, so far as like knowing about anybody, I'd probably say that that you know, you read a journal, and you write a few things in there, you know, such as, you know, going to the class, you know, to turn in the paper or something like that, and then it's like somebody that wrote something, and then knowing about, I'm like, yeah, that knowing about that they actually could read something, it's like, you know, they looked at it once, and then after about a few days later that they still remembered about what the note said, what the letter said it was. And we'll say the type of names that we have for that, especially. But on our hand, and knowing about, if most of us knowing about, you know, from the study about, you know, for language arts, is knowing about, it's like you have, like, here is, you know, to add that, you know, for if most of us were to work this, like, the email, and you have, like, say, these, I guess you call it, say, the quotation, you know, not the quotations, but the, you know, slashes, you see the vertical slash or something like that, where you type in, you know, for the internet site, and then along right here, as you have right here, is, I say, the quotations and periods, parentheses, you know, those type of keys that could be located on the keyboard. It is, but basically though, that if we look at my my picture right here, is that I'll be working right here. Is that you have right here is the 4B pencil, and for the most part though, that you know, if we were to be writing a letter or any type of journal, and knowing about anybody, probably think about, you know, what's the reason? Because on your hand too, that nobody is going to want to read about me. I'm like, I may have, you know, said this, you know, quite a few times, is knowing about that, you know, the types of stories, and anybody probably think about, like, you know, what's so interesting about the story, you know, from my own feedback or anything like that, about what I think about this or that, and just knowing about that. For if we, if the teachers want us to maybe sit down and write a journal, or maybe write a, you know, three or four papers about what you think about this subject, and, you know, for what we're talking about, if it's in the classroom, or if it's anything that's related to, you know, job, you know, any type of job offer, or you know, anything that's mentioned, of course, in the group, it is that they want to maybe want to read about your feedback, it is, and anybody made me think about, I'm like, yeah, that I used to be like that too, where that really that I'll just go ahead and say it, I'm not going to write it, and that, you know, there may be some people that, of course, that may have problems, you know, reading and writing, and I know a lot of times, though, that especially if it's going to be done, like, say, on a maybe on a Nook or a tablet or something like that. But if you have, I see that, you know, piece of paper, like, say, a paper like this right here, too, we have some writing on there, you know, for papers keepers. But on your hand, that knowing about, with most of the time, anybody that may wonder, though, that goes by saying is like, that knowing about, you know, that the types of things that maybe you discover about, you know, if you write something and all of a sudden it's like that, you know, part of what you wrote is pronounced, of course, maybe in German, or if it's Latin or some language like that. And like with anybody that may wonder, though, I'm like, yeah, like I would probably say that whenever I write something that I keep thinking about, that sometimes my handwriting is pretty sloppy at some point, but then on your hand too, that knowing about whenever I write it in, you know, maybe, you know, on a, you know, if I were to be working emails or anything like that, or like a journal, writing journals, you know, mysteries or anything like that. And I can tell anybody here that by the time I get started with something, you know, such as if I were to be writing a story about, let's just say, about maybe what I did, you know, last weekend or something like that, and they only ask for about maybe two or three paragraphs, and it's possible that maybe, you know, a lot of times you'll get making sure that the cap lock is off, because I can tell anybody here that whenever I start typing, is knowing about, it's like to make sure that the cap lock is off, because a couple times it seems like it comes on automatically. But you have right here is that let's just say that you know some people they may call it like for to expand. It's like for brain power it is, and like with anybody that may wonder though, that for the most part though that that for whatever that we learn about for if it's based on TV or on the radio or if it's on the computer or reading a book and like with anybody may think that reading though that. I may explain before, but then anybody probably saying, "Mike, well, really? But what's new?" But on your hand, that knowing about that, like with me though, that whenever I read stuff, that sometimes depend on what you're in the mood for reading, and then after you read it, and then they want you to go ahead and write something about it. Is it more exciting to look forward to writing about it compared to reading about something? And a few books that, of course, I have around here, I haven't read them all, and anybody may think about, I'm like, yeah, that if you were to check them out maybe at the library, then they may be passed to you, et cetera, et cetera. But on the hand, at knowing about that, with most of the time, with like, say, if it's increasing skills and brain power, it is knowing about that. That with basics about is a that is to discover about maybe that's something that maybe you can do and knowing about something that that you can do that maybe impresses a few other people that that you may have talked to and anybody probably think about how did you do that or something like that and if you realized about that that whatever that you wrote is maybe about something that's may or never been found before something or that has been used in a while or they didn't know that you could do that. Or something like that, and like with anybody, I can tell anybody here. I mainly look forward to impressing people, like talking about that. Anybody probably think that that whenever you, if I were to write a paper and find out that that's the wrong language, or you're not supposed to type like that. You're supposed to type with that space, center, tab, but in the center, and like you leave a few spaces down below, stuff like that. That type of stuff. More likely anybody think about anything that could be done on a typewriter. I'm like, yeah, you spend about 2 hours on it and find out that's still not good enough. That's not how you do it, et cetera, et cetera. But on the other hand, knowing about anybody that may think that I'm like, way I think about though, is that whenever I type words, that a lot of times I kind of realize of knowing about the after I start thinking of ideas of what I want to type, and then I start typing. And whenever I start typing, that sometimes I have to check the cap, the spelling corrections about the spell check, and then after that, and then I kind of go back and look at it, and sometimes though I can tell anybody here that typing may seem kind of boring, especially that if you're going to be writing about journal about what you did and what you discovered and. Maybe something that you like to do, et cetera, et cetera. And besides, everybody has their own way of learning, but on your hand, too, that knowing about is like the story, though, is that if there's ever been a point of the story to where something that you wrote, and then after several weeks or several months later, that maybe somebody else reads it, and then they become interested, if it's romantic story or if it's anything that's related to a skill that you didn't think that you were good at it until you were looking for that person to like, you didn't think that it would be published in the papers, whichever it is. But on your hand, the way I think about it, besides you say story about the message in the bottle of knowing about right here, for the peepers, the paper keepers stories, it is basically talking about right here of knowing about that the type of language is knowing about for how we write stuff, for how we type papers it is, and type letters and stuff, and like with anybody that may, this is like, say, my, this was a drawing, from my student photo, and I went and drew right there as a moon along with it, but I keep thinking, though, that, for most of us, that if we would be talking to somebody that, they'll talk about, say, the type of homework and knowing about if we would be talking to other people and you're talking about if it's the great, the grandparents, the ones that have been, that they've been, like I say, they passed away about, a few, nearly 7 or 8 years ago. And then maybe you may still dream about them, talking to them and then you ask them a question, et cetera, et cetera. I'm like, what do you kind of call that type of of you say, what do you call that type of understanding? But anybody that may think that I'm like, yeah, that something that more likely that you may discover knowing about something that that you may have, that more likely maybe a doctor, you know, therapist, dermatologist that may not be able to recover about, you know, say the test results, such as that you got like a some type of a communication about knowing about that you can actually talk, that you can actually, you know, how I describe it, you can actually picture in your mind knowing about that you actually, you know, communicate with the person though. But well, I didn't too, that knowing about, you know, different ways. I'm sure anybody probably say that there's probably thousands of different ways of, you know, of sources of communication it is. But but one thing that, of course, to keep in mind though is knowing about that the yeah that knowing about it's like, you know, for ways of about, you know, about our education, knowing about anybody probably think that that yeah that that, you know, I don't have a story to tell because nobody wants to hear it, and I don't think anybody ever will want to hear it. But the way I think about it, that anybody probably say that, hey, I'm like, you know, you remember writing the letters, don't you? I'm like, yeah, well, I only, like, and that during that time that I was telling her about something that was going on over the weekend or something like that, or if it was anything that's related to education, you know, anything that's related to a field trip or maybe any special occasion or anything like that, you'll miss you, you'll talk to you soon, you know, something like that. But like with anybody that may wonder though, that really, I'm like, you know, who would want to read about, you know, anybody might think, you know, who would want to read about me? I'm like, talking about is like, you know, the type of stories, and like with anybody, probably saying, I go by the stories of knowing about, you know, somebody who, you know, discovered, like, what you calls, like, you know, the smart lens or something like that, or if it's anything that's related to, the fact about, like, yeah, a new way of, how to key in your language, your writings, like anything that's using any type of program it is, and reading sources. And anybody could probably say that, you know, I'm not talking about too much like anything that you would maybe see on one of those movies like Dr. Doolittle, but where you talk to animals. But let's just say that a type of language to where that you can actually understand people and understand about, you know, before they speak, knowing about exactly about what they say. And then on your hand too, that knowing about anybody probably say about, what do you call that, especially whenever you dream the dream that seems so real, and then find out that, you know, you were dreaming that you were actually there at that certain location, and you asked them the questions and they gave you the answers. And anybody probably think about, yeah, that's a, it's all just what you call a matter of the fantasy dream. But, you know, this so-called fantasy dream, knowing about, really, about the difference between dreams and reality, of knowing about that, the, yeah, that is that some type of a certain, you know, a certain, you know, way of how the brain works, of knowing about that type of medical study it is known as, like, for education, though. But, but I already hand to know about anybody probably thinking about, you know, a type of story based on what I had to say about it. I know about, say, for between dreams and jobs and education goes. I've known about, I kept thinking about that, that yeah, a lot of things that I think that, that were what you call, you know, for, you know, made up or anything like that. And, you know, one of those is, of course, is knowing about, say, with my handwriting, and knowing about that a couple times, and anybody probably saying, I'm like, you know, how did you learn how to write that small, and according to Microsoft Word or something like that, that the, that you can change, you say that, you know, the T, I guess you call it, you know, the T pin, you know, T alphabets or something like that. You can actually change the word headings for, like, say, the size quality of the texting and whether the typing it is. And anybody probably think about, I'm like, yeah, that if you want to say, you know, something such as which calls like the speech, you know, I'm like, you know, anybody think about that. It's like a toss, say, you know, for the, see here, besides speaking, you know, for speech, but, anyway, but here, right here, it's like for speech, like toss, say, for speech and then language, but anyway, The on your hand too, that knowing about, like, the way that we read and write, and then how we write our names, etc., etc., and then knowing about, for space in between, it is, if you want to leave some space in between and then write something else, such as what you call your weekend or something like that. Weekend, holiday. See, hi, see, or holiday, but anyway, whenever I'm getting ready to write something, of course, maybe in journal or anything like that, I tend to, like you say, use the backspace a lot of times and work with the controls and stuff. But on the hand to anybody, maybe think about, is like, yeah, that there are some times to where I write maybe a few paragraphs and I kind of look back and look at the screen and see that there's no mistakes. What do you call that, to where you usually make at least one mistake inside of a 45, texting, or maybe if it's 100 or so words, you usually make a mistake. But on your hand too, anybody probably saying, like, that really about, is there a part of the story to where that, people are extremely curious about how you arrived at your answer, knowing about something that you learned and you discovered about, how to type like this, how to learn like this, how to think like this, whichever it is. And anybody that may think about, I'm like, yeah, that there are probably several hundred other students that are more likely to have a better answer than other than I do. But on the hand, knowing about, it's like, how did you learn how to, speak Spanish or work Latin or anything like that? But on the hand too, to knowing about, the type of calculator, knowing about, what kind of one I'll, use whenever I was in school was, but just knowing about that, really about, for, a certain story of, like, what you call is, like, the paper keepers, is knowing about that if we have a part of the story to where that anybody that may ask, and, like, everybody going to want to, be extremely curious and knowing about, what exactly does that mean, or what's this or what's that, something like that. But so far as for our education, though, that whenever I read some of the wordings, like if I were to be taking an exam or a test, I keep thinking about that. I know what it says, but it's telling me now that it's, is this a verb, or if it's a pronouns, or if it's a topic sentence or anything like that. And sometimes I would mark my answer for what I think the best answer is, and sometimes my scores would not be very good, so far as, for the IQ, but on the hand, that knowing about is like, so far as the story is, knowing about that, really about anybody probably think that, yeah, that I have a story that I don't know if everybody needs to know about it, such as dreams and of course, discoveries or anything like that. But on the hand too, that knowing about is the remembering, and knowing about, for those that, really want to hear, the voice for, for how I speak, of knowing about, it's like, for really, it's kind of a, it's real interesting, and knowing about that, by the time somebody discovers something or sees something, it just seems like the story just keeps continuing going on, and then the whole point of the story seems like it gets juicier, knowing about, I'm like, yeah, it gets real interesting as time goes on. It seems like it keeps getting interesting, knowing about that, the whole part about, yep, that we just never know, when it, the jobs and then the task and stuff like that, they are considered done. Because on your hand too, the more that we keep ourselves busy, and then the more that more likely that you probably say about, almost everybody, everybody has a dream, everybody has a story. But then on your hand too, does everybody want to do it? Does everybody want to talk about it? Does everybody want to do what it takes just to share the story, etc., etc.? But on the hand too, that knowing about is like the basic communication about the paper keeper stories of talking about right here, of like, you have right there is me reading the paper. And sometimes anybody probably think about that, sometimes you don't look at the paper, you actually have it memorized. And some people that may say that, yeah, well, I wrote it and I know what it means, but on your hand too, that's just my handwriting. I don't know why you think of it as treasure or gold, because it's not precious, it's not treasure, it's just my own handwriting. But anybody could probably say about, you just might be surprised what you may find out at knowing about, somebody else that may learn something about, about you or us, something like that. But all I had to say, talk about, say, the paper keeper story, knowing about that, you just never know about what other people think, I say, about your work, but knowing about, like I say, the paper keeper stories kind of activity. Well, hello there, everyone. And like talking about, say, the paper keeper stories is like talking about, I say, you got the culinary activity right here. And like anybody that may wonder, though, basically about the stories, about, our education, knowing about anybody that may wonder, though, like with me, though, that whenever we're young, that we may think about all kinds of, keep our minds open for a lot of things, for possibilities, it is, things that we want to do and, to try out, et cetera, et cetera. But on your hand, too, anybody probably think about what you usually feel like whenever you fail something, such as if you take a class and you wind up failing it, maybe the first and second time it is. Anybody that may say that, I'm like, yeah, if you go out and apply for a job and they ask you about your experience and, of course, your education, if you have a degree and et cetera, such and such, training event like this, so far, working with products, computer programmings, stuff like that, and like say for writing and then book publishing, it's like materials, stuff like that. And basically, to anybody, I think that Mike, that if they completed about maybe a year or two or three or so, gotten their master's degree or something like that, or associate's degree in something, and then that they may think that Mike, well, that's not enough, just to be able to get this position or something like that, or you need to go back to school or something like that. If you apply for a job, and let's just say 7 years later that you go out and apply for a job, and then they may say, well, you gotta go, it's time to go back to school. I can, who, me? Oh, no. I mean, that was, that was back in the early, 2000s or something like that. I'm like, that was 10 years ago. I'm too old for that now. And anybody you probably think about, I'm like, yeah, you usually hear that saying, I'm like, you're too old for something. And usually, how do people usually say it? Knowing about, for the paper's keepers, and knowing about, like, how do you know whenever you're too old for something? And just knowing about anybody that may wonder, though, that, really about, it's like the type of smart, knowing about, for basically about our education, and know about how much work are we willing to put into something, as knowing about is like for the hard work, and then knowing about safe with honesty and trust it is. And I could anybody that may wonder, though, about our education, I'm like, whenever, this, portrait right here, that I would have been about maybe 15, 16 years old right here. And I kept thinking about that. I'm like, yeah, that I was maybe too young to work at a certain position, especially maybe the computer labs or something like that. Like anybody probably think about, you have so many years to where you think that you're too young to work here, and then by the time you get older, and now you're like, oh, well, I'm too old for that. I'm like, but anybody probably think about, I'm like, hey, it's about more likely by keeping your mind open for this possibility, other than thinking about, oh, well, you're not at all enough, or you're too old for that, or something like that. But on your hand, anybody that may think about that, what do you usually feel like whenever you fail something? If you fail a class, and then you say that after you fail it, after the fifth time, you don't want to take it again. Anybody think about, I'm like, you go into this frustrations, such as you write down your notes, and then you're like, doing studies. It's like, yeah, that, I'm like, you where say with the studying, and spend so much time doing this right here, reading the notes, and then and you look at that grade report, and then it says something like what you call, maybe such and such, minus or plus this or something like that. And like with anybody that may wonder about if we study, but anybody may think that, like what I may have said before, that maybe the more time that we focus is knowing about that. I don't know about if we have to have the study book, I'd say about, you don't need to take it to the coffee shop with you, or to the library, or around town with you. You don't have to have it with you at the lunch table, at the breakfast table, or at the dinner table, it is, etc., etc. But on the other hand, too, that knowing about the whole important part, I'd be more likely about studying, knowing about something to remember by, knowing about, the things that you would need, that are required just to, succeed, pass in the classes, though. Anybody that may wonder, though, is that maybe that there's like a certain time period, and knowing that, there's a time to where if you're willing to spend at least
maybe what you call 2 hours a day, and maybe at least maybe 2 or 3,000 hours out of a month, studying something, it's possible that you may show your better progress. So, on your hand, anybody that may think that going to college, whenever they're in their mid-40s and they want to go out and get a job, something like that, or get like open up a business, whichever it is, and just thinking about that, any papers that they may still have or they may not still have, et cetera, and then they may like, well, you have a college degree, but then on your hand too, then with your experience, you need to have more experience, or you need to have a higher source of education. And anybody that may think of like, well, between if you pass and you fail, and then knowing about how old you are, and knowing about how young and old you gotta be, just to take a certain course. And like with anybody that may think about that, really about if you work something like this, like say with the language, it's like it's so for spelling though. Anybody may think about that you've done a number of mistakes to where that it's like people are thinking about, in order to work this program, it's like, yeah, that especially on a touch, keypad it is, it's like press, T-I, C-C, or something like that, you touch the keypad. And like anybody probably think about that, if they want me to go ahead and do like what you call 13 words per minute, how is that possible? Because I mean, I'll be lucky enough if I get 5 words, if I get 5 words in a minute, because it's like trying to look for the word. But anybody probably think about, I'm like, how do you do this? How do you do that? How do you adjust that? I'm like that the things that more likely that what you can do with your time, and knowing about that, yeah, that the adjustments that you can make, it is, how do you do that? I'm like, I guess it's basically that you're training your mind, you're training your brain, of course, the basic jobs that's required, and sometimes you just do it just by for how you learnt, for what you were trained by. So in a lot of ways, anybody that may say that. Really, that is time, is there an expiration, that there's expired time from our education, knowing about if it's a college degree or if it's experience, maybe in the military, an academy or something like that, of knowing about it's like for to work hard for what you like, for work hard but what you want to accomplish, anybody think about, no matter what. I'm like anybody that may say whichever, but just knowing about that those who may say, maybe you want to talk you down at times, and knowing about you failed it 3 times, you failed it 10 times, you don't need to try it again, you're just not good enough for it. But on the hand too, I guess you can always just, it's like, like tell them, say, for the best of luck, the best of luck. It's more likely is all for for what's accomplished. But on your hand and knowing about is like for the best of luck for for whoever that is thinking about, for say for the brighter future, knowing about understanding about the paper keepers story is talk, I'd say we each it seems like we each have a story about how we get that degree, how we get that job, how we get to this point and then to that point, et cetera, et cetera. A long story, whichever it is. And it seems like that anybody probably think about it, anybody who asks or anything like that, and knowing about it's an embarrassing long story. It's something that I don't think anybody would understand. But on the hand, and knowing about that, really, it just seems like anything that we may think that a story to about whatever we do in life, or as a young kid it is, knowing about if there's a certain connection, knowing about is anybody else gonna want to know about this, anybody else gonna want to know about that, anybody else gonna want to hear about that. And on your hand too, that knowing about it's like for them, the papers keeper stories is talking about is like the things, of course, like the kind of, and even if we do fail, of talking about is like, yeah, that anybody that may think about, yeah, what does it usually feel like whenever you, whenever you fail, it is, I'm like, you kind of feel like what you call, that, you kind of like want to sit back like this and stretch, whichever it is, but on your hand too, relax and just knowing about, I'm like, yeah, that, and more likely, they usually say that you just gotta work more, you work harder, and concentrate, study more, you know, work hard for what you do best, but on your hand and knowing about you for what the goal is, but on your hand and knowing about it's like for the paper's keepers is knowing about is that the important knowing about it's like for education. And anybody that may think about it, that really about the whole purpose about the story here is knowing about, you know, this may be just the piece of paper right here that maybe has a few things on it, but just knowing about maybe that, you know, more likely from how my education goes is knowing about anybody that may say I'm like that, yeah, that what has improved, you know, of course, whenever you were working on that, what has improved and knowing about, you know, about our education, if it's all about improving the skills or if it's all about maybe anybody saying about, maybe about lecturing, anything like that, talking about, you know, to keep talking bad about it, you know, you failed it already. You know, you can't take it again, you're not going to take it again, but anybody that may say it, Mike, well, just know is that, you know, even if you fail, you know, fail, that may mean fail, but then on your hand too, it does not mean what you call fall, you know, collapse, but on your hand too, knowing about, in order for the paper to get back on its feet, knowing about is like to give it a year or two and just thinking about, you know, hey, yeah, I've been out of school for 20 years. I've been out of school for 10 years. I've been out of school for 5 years. I've been out of school for a year. I've been out of school for 30 years. You know, I'm too old for that now. It just seems like the story just goes on, don't it? But other than that, like talking right here, is that you just never know for who want to know about us. You know, about you. You know, us it isn't knowing about. It's like tough for us, you know, for the story, you know, letters that, keepers is like to say collectivity.